Hello, I'm Dr. Jeon, Inseoung from Dental Bean. The patient undergoing surgery today is a 67-year-old male. This patient has had several implants in the past, but over time, the bone around the implants on 33 and 34 of the right lower jaw has significantly deteriorated. However, since these two implants are supporting a one-piece bridge, for now, we decided to leave the lower jaw as it is. Currently, the upper jaw has three implants supporting a bridge, which is also functioning well. So we will leave it alone for now today, since it hasn't been long since the implant on the left upper was removed, and the soft tissue has not fully healed. It would be better to wait a bit longer for this area. Today, we plan to place implants the right upper jaw. Currently, there isn't much residual bone in the sinus. We will approach laterally and place two implants to align with the lower jaw, and the rest can be done later. Today, we will use Dentis' SQ implant, utilizing the currently highly regarded SQVA system, to accurately measure the bone density between the two implants. We plan to remove implant number 27 with the Dentis Save Remove Kit. However, there is one screw visible here, so we believe it needs to be removed to easily use Dentis Save Remove Kit. We will proceed with this during the surgery.
Thank you.
these are the post-operation observations. The residual bone is about 3 to 4 meters in the front and about 2 meters in the back, but during the alignment process in the back, we lost some initial stability, so we placed a 06.0x10mm SQ implant. In the front, we used a 05.0x10mm implant. The bone graft used today is IB Dental's eye bone and allograft, which consists of 50% cortical and 50% cancellous bone. We mixed eye bone with PRF membrane and grafted it together. We plan to accurately compare the results of using SQVE and not using it in the future. We attempted to use the save remove kit for implant on Neo 27, but due to a fractured screw, we removed it using the screw retriever from the universal kit. After that, we removed the implant with the save remove kit. Implants on Dandier 15 and number 16 will likely be completed with prostheses in about 5 months. We plan to complete the right side first and then finalize it later through a maxillary sinus lift. Looking at the number 15 area before the surgery, I performed some crestal flattening on this sharp area. These are the post-operative observations. This is the number 16 area and its post-operative observation. Here, there was significant bleeding, but the membrane was not perforated. The bleeding caused a slightly radiopaque appearance similar to an air fluid level. This will naturally clear up in about 4 weeks. We will provide an update after the final prosthesis is completed in about 6 months. Thank you.